Hey there, it's Anna Vaughn. And this is Luna Tuna, just waking up from a nap. We're going to do a Q&A today. A lot of people have been writing and wondering, where are we? What is going on? So I asked on Instagram and Facebook for you to send in your questions, and I would answer them today. If you like this video, give it a like. If you want to share with your friends, I'm not mad at that. And you can always subscribe to our channel to get more fun with the Travel Mama and the Luna Tuna. Okay, so question number one. So Eddie Perez wrote to me and said, are you ever coming back to Antigua? Oh, she's awake. And the answer is yes, we are coming back to Antigua. We're just traveling right now. We've been in Vancouver, and if you've been watching the channel, we've been in Canada for a couple of weeks. I'm actually doing this video from the beautiful island of Bali, and if you keep watching, you're gonna see a lot of amazing videos featuring us here in Bali. My next question, also about moving, is, are you moving to Canada or Bali? And the answer is no, we're not. I got that one from Facebook from Evelyn Gonzalez, and Evelyn, don't worry, we are not moving to Asia. It's just that we're taking an extended trip just for fun. Before Luna turns two, she only travels for the taxes, so I don't have to get her an extra seat, and I'm taking advantage of that by doing our last big trip before you become a big girl. Finally, Jamina asked me on Instagram, am I moving to Guatemala City? Yes or no? And if so, why? So this is a really loaded question. We've actually wanted to move out of Antigua for quite some time, and Guatemala City offers a lot more for kids. There's a lot more for my age bracket. Antigua is beautiful. The only thing is, it's over 50% tourist. Most of the tourists are either under 25 or over 65, which means there isn't a lot for me to do. I'm almost 40. Beer pong and ladies' night, not so much my thing anymore, you know? I want to go to an art show, check out some, you know, new restaurants, see some live music, do stuff from 7 to 9 p.m. You know, they've got more yoga studios in the city. They've got more things for me to do. You know, more dating options. I mean, she's almost two. It's time for me to go on a date. Are we moving to the city right away? No. The answer is no, we're not. But I plan on spending a lot more time in the city when I get back. Expect to see us in Guatemala City on weekends, starting probably somewhere in November or December. And we'll see if we move there. If we do, you guys will be the very first people to know about it. Our next question comes from Benny on Instagram. He asks, is Luna Canadian, Chapina, or Mexican? And you know what? This has been asked a lot in the comments, and there's even been fights in the comments about it, about what Luna is. So I'm gonna put it all to rest now. Luna was born in Mexico. So she has a Mexican passport because she was born on Mexican soil. I'm her only parent, and I'm Canadian. So she's Canadian and Mexican. Those are the two passports that she has. That's technically what she is on paper. The thing is, Luna's biological father is Guatemalan. So by blood, she's Canadian from me and Guatemalan from him. Because she only has one parent from Canada, she doesn't have a Guatemalan passport, and we're not residents. So she's only Guatemalan because I know she is, I say she is, and I've told you guys. So I like to think that she's a little of all three. We're very grateful to Mexico, and we definitely feel at home there. But at the same time, we live in Guatemala, and I mean, by blood, she's Guatemalan and Canadian. And those are the three cultures that I really hope that she continues to enjoy for the rest of her life. So Lauren Farrell, I think I'm saying her name right, wrote in from Instagram to ask, what is the visa situation like in Central America and or Asia, and is it easy to stay as a foreigner? We're on a tourist visa here in Bali. Upon entry, you get 30 days to stay. Then you gotta leave for at least 24 hours and come back to renew your visa, or you can extend it for 30 more days, but then you definitely have to leave. In Central America, it's a lot easier. For Guatemala, you get 90 days. When you enter, you can extend for 90 more, and then you have to leave. So you really only have to leave every 6 months. other places can be even easier. Like Mexico, for instance. If you go to Mexico, you get up to 6 months, 180 days upon entry. So you have to leave even less. This, of course, I'm talking about from a Canadian and American perspective, because usually it's people from Canada or the States that ask me this question most, because it's so hard to stay in those countries as a foreigner. To be honest, you can travel the world on tourist visas for a long time. There are people that live here that leave every 60 days and have been living here for years like that. Okay, here's the next question. This one comes from Kira Enlow from Instagram. She asks, how did you come up with the idea to start your company Pink Mafia, and how did you get the balls to do it at such a young age? So Kira knows a little bit more about me. We've chatted a bit online, and I started a company called Pink Mafia when I was 23 and living in Toronto, Canada. And initially I was a promoter and I threw parties for people in the music industry and also the public. Eventually it grew into an online magazine and party promotion. I was launching nightclubs and I started a street team. I kind of just came out of need. I was doing an all-girl DJ tour called Get Her Done across Canada, and I wanted people to put up flyers and posters promoting our shows, and I didn't want it to be some skeezy old dude. I was like, can't we just get some like cute girls in knee socks and, you know, short shorts to do this? And I just ended up getting my own people. At the time, I was like in my mid-20s, so I knew people in universities, and it was easy to find somebody to do it. Over time, I decided to retire when I was 30. I left the country, and I just kept the street team because I could do it online. Now, if you go to pinkmafia.ca, if you're in Canada and you need a product or an event promoted, we operate in 13 markets across the country. To be honest, I really just started the company as a way to do what I was doing anyway, which was promoting events I was going to. I was taking photos for online music magazines and writing and stuff, and I just wanted to keep doing that. I was telling people where to go anyway, and so I just wanted to do my own thing and get paid for it. It slowly over time grew into a bigger company, and when I decided I wanted to leave Canada, I felt like I had spent so much of my life building this company. I mean, I was your classic working 80 hours a week, you know, this work hard, play hard bullshit, you know, spending money on stuff I didn't need. I was unhappy, I was unhealthy, and I wanted to get out of that. But I also didn't want to leave behind this company I had grown, and it just made sense to automate it. Now it's like 10 years later since automating it. This is what I do. I make enough money to live outside of Canada, but not enough to be in Canada. I love my job. I'm good at it. I enjoy it. I've got the maps of the whole country, all the cities in my head. That's really what saves me. And, you know, it's a small industry. Most people don't run a national company in my field. So we're kind of like the best by virtue of being the only one. And that's it. I mean, it didn't really take balls. I was 23. I mean, that's all you are, is like ideas. I mean, I was thinking, I want to do this for a year or two, you know? And with the street team, I just saw an opportunity to work online and travel. This was way before digital nomads existed. And to be honest, I'm really offended when people call me a digital nomad. Even though technically it's what I am, I'm not nomadic. I live in Guatemala. I have a home. My daughter and I have a home. I am not nomadic at all. When I think of a digital nomad, I think of someone that is doing data entry so that they can continue partying after university. I worked my ass off to grow this company in my 20s. I sacrificed my time. I sacrificed energy. I almost sacrificed my health mentally and physically for it. You know, I feel like I'm more than a digital nomad. I'm a CEO of a national marketing company in Canada that does pretty well for my industry. And I'll leave links below if you're interested in any way of looking into that, but this also answers the question, how do you fund your travels? I think the most fun question that I got out of all of these on Facebook and Instagram was from Brittany Vasquez, who just said, talk about the parasite. So if you've been following us online, you know that I got a parasite when I came here. I actually think I picked it up in Canada, and it's pretty common that I get sick when I go to Canada now. The parasite story, I don't know where I got it. I might have gotten it from eating way too much of everything in Vancouver. you know, plus I got on a plane. Planes are hard on the immune system. And then when I got off the plane, I went and ate street food right away. So I could have gotten it from any of those places. It wasn't necessarily dirty street food, which is what people think when they think, oh, I got sick on vacation, so that place is dirty. I could have gotten it from the airplane food, which, to be honest, is probably 10 times dirtier. And I could have gotten it in Vancouver. I could have gotten it anywhere. That's the parasite story. The lucky part is, here in Bali, you can just go to a pharmacy and tell them what you have, and they can help you right there. You don't need to go to a doctor. Same in Guatemala. And, you know, I took some parasite medication, and I've been taking high-dose probiotics ever since. It's a really good idea to travel with a good, strong probiotic so that your body is stronger when it comes into contact with new water, new food, new climate, new environment, new sleeping habits, all of it. And I do recommend, if you're traveling with children, to get them some kids probiotics just to like strengthen up their tummy, because they do have a tendency to drink pool water and all kinds of other stuff. You can buy them at any pharmacy, pretty much anywhere in the world, for super cheap. You don't need a prescription. Luna and I travel with them all the time for her, and they seem to work out her little like Bali belly, Delhi belly, Guate belly, whatever you want to call it. Anyway, that's the end of my question and answer. I hope you guys got your questions answered, and we'll do another one of these later. Feel free to ask me anytime. You can get a hold of me on my Instagram or Facebook. Links for both are below. Have a really great day.